welcome back to my channel. Today we shall start a new chapter, chapter number 5, which is the lies and anger. In our last video, we learned to solve the problems based on linear equation. I hope you would like all the video and enjoy to solving the question. So let us start a new chapter, that is the lies and anger. And here we will discuss about the new topics which based on angle and line. You also know about the lines and angle and also learned in your previous classes. So first let us revise what is the line and angle. After that we will start the topic which based on this chapter. So let us start from the angle lines. What is the line? As we know that a small part of a line is known as a line segment. So if we draw a line segment, then this is the line segment AB. In this line segment, we can see that the line segment has two endpoints. The first point is A and the second endpoint is B. And if we extend both endpoints to the infinite in the opposite direction, if we extend the both endpoint to the infinite in opposite direction, then such geometrical figure is known as the line, because here the line has no midpoint and we can say that its length will be infinite, because the both head shows that they extend to the infinite. So here it is impossible to find out its midpoint, because if we suppose that this is the O, which is the midpoint of the line, then we are not sure that which end will extend to infinite. If it's in this end goes to infinite, then the point O will never remain to be its midpoint. And if its B, the point B is remain constant and the point A goes to infinite, then also O will not remain to be its midpoint. So we say that in the line, we are not able to find out its midpoint. And what is the line? A line segment. When the both endpoint of a line segment goes to infinite, then such geometrical figure is known as a line. And we also discussed about the ray. What is the ray? When a line segment is said to be a ray, when its only one point goes to the infinite and other point is remain fixed, then such type of geometrical figure is known as a ray. Here the second figure shows that this is a ray, because in this we can see that there is the point A and this is the point B, and also we can see that there is only one end point which is extended to infinite, so that the geometrical figure is known as a ray. Here the point A, which is to be fixed, is known as the initial point. The point which is fixed in the ray is known as the initial point. You can take the example of sun. As we know that the light comes to us from the sun in the form of ray, so that the sun can be assumed that a fixed point, and the light which comes to us can be assumed, it is obvious that it comes in the form of ray, so that the sun is the initial point and its one end can be go to infinite. So this is a ray which is defined as a line segment is said to be a ray if its one end goes to infinite and other end is remain constant. The fixed point of the ray is known as the initial point. Here first we will discuss about the angle, and also we discuss about the various type of angle. Here the special thing is in this chapter is that we shall discuss about the types of angle, but these types of angle are based on the pair of angle. So here our aim is to define the various type of pair of angle. So let me explain first angle. What is the angle? As we know about the ray, so we can define the angle with the help of ray. We say that when two rays join at the same point, then such geometrical figure is known as an angle. Here we can see that this is a ring OP and this is a ring OQ. So when these two rays are joined at the same point like this, then we can say that this geometrical figure is known as an angle. Here we can see that there are two rays. The first ray is OP and the second ray is OQ, and both are rays joined at the point O. So we say that such geometrical figure is known as an angle, and the fixed point O is known as the vertex of the angle, and the ray OB and OQ are known as the arms of the angle. Now let us start the various type of pair of angle. What do you mean by the pair of angle? When we take two angles of any measurement, then such angles are known as pair of angle. So here we define the types of angle. So let's start. Types of pair of angles. There are various type of pair of angles such as complementary angle, second supplementary angle. Angles. Third one is linear pair angle. Next one is vertically opposite angle. And the last is angles around a point. Angles around a point. These are the various types of pairs of angles which we are to be defined. So let's define these angles one by one. So let us start from the complementary angle. When two angles are said to be complementary, we define the complementary angle and the supplementary angle and also the linear pair of these three angles on the basis of their measurement. So we define the complementary angle when we say that two angles, or when we say that a pair of angles is to be complementary angle. If the sum of their measure is 90 degrees, then such two angles are known as complementary. Two angles are said to be complementary angles if the sum of their measure is 90 degrees. So such type of angle is known as complementary angle. Here we can see that by example, this is an angle of 60 degrees and this is an angle of 30 degrees. So here we can see that there are two angles are given. The first angle, which is the measure of 60 degrees, and the second angle, which has the measure of 30 degrees. And if we take the sum of these two measurements, then we get 60 plus 30, and this is equal to 90 degrees. That means these two angles are the complementary angles, and we draw the figure in the combination form like that. So that we can say that this is the complementary angle. I hope what is the complementary angle is clear. Two angles are said to be complementary angle if the sum of their measure is 90 degree. Then such type of angle are known as complementary angle. And there is a remark for the complementary angle is that what do these two angles are called to each other? If these two angles are the complementary angle, then each angle are known as the complement of each other. Here we can say that the first angle is the complement of the second angle of 30 degree, or the angle of 30 degree is the complement of the first angle of 60 degree. So that we say that each angle are known as the complement of each other. And also we can see by the example the angle of 60 degree and the angle of 30 degree, both angles are known as the complementary angle, and the combination form of this complementary angle can also be called like this. This was that a complementary angle. Now let's do some question on the complementary angle. Okay, here we need not draw the angle. If we just give the measure of the angle, then we can also define complementary angle by just seeing the measure of the given angle. If just suppose that there are some pair of angle are given like this, first is 45 degree and 55 degree, the second one is 70 degree and 20 degree, third is 40 degree and 50 degree. The third is, fourth one is 50 degree, 40 degree and 55 degree. Here some measure of angles are given and we have to find out which pairs are the complementary angle and which pairs are not the complementary angle. We just verify by seeing the measure of the angle and getting their sum. Here we can see that in the first question, the measure of two angles are 45 degree and 55 degree. And if we add them, then we get 45 plus 55, and this will give 100. And as we know that two angles are said to be complementary angles if the sum of their measure is 90 degrees. But in the first case, we can see that the sum of their measure is 100 degrees. So we can say that the first pair is not a complementary angle. So let's see the next. In the second, when we add them, then we get 70 degrees plus 20 degrees, and this gives 90 degrees. And here we can see that the sum of the measure of given pair is 90 degrees. And then according to the definition, we can say that the second pair is the complementary angle. Similarly, let's see in the third question, when we add them, then we get 40 degrees plus 50 degrees, and this also gives 90 degrees, which means that the third pair is also complementary angle. And in the fourth case, when we add 40 plus 55 degrees, then we get 95 degrees. And here, as we know that the sum of the measure of two angles is 90 degrees, then such angle are known as the complementary angle. And here in the last case, we get 95 as the sum of the pair of the given angle. That means this is not the complementary angle. I hope the idea of complementary angle is understood by every student clearly. Now let us start the next topic, that is the supplementary angle. supplementary metal. When we say that the pair of metal is supplementary, if the sum of their measure be straight angle, if the sum of their measure be straight angle, that is 180 degree, then such types of pair are known as the supplementary angle. Here we can see that two angles are here. The first angle is, this is the angle of 60 degree, and the second angle is like this. This is the angle of 120 degree. Here we can see that the two pair of angles is given, and if we find out the sum of their measure, then we get 180 degree, which means the pair of 60 degree angle and 120 degree angle are the supplementary angles. So we define that two angles are said to be supplementary angle if the sum of their measure is 180 degree. So here we can see that these two angles of 60 degree and 120 degree are said to be supplementary angles because their sum is 180 degrees. And in the combination form, we draw the figure like this. This is the angle of 60 degree and this is the angle of 120 degree. And the sum of 60 and 120 is the straight angle. So we say that this is the supplementary angle. I hope the definition is clear. Let's do some practice on such type of angles. If the measure of some pair are given like this, 90 plus 100, second one is 45 plus 135, third is 90 plus 90 degree, fourth is 160 plus 20 degree. There are two pairs given and we have to find out their sum, and also we have to justify which pair is supplementary angle. So let's see one by one. If we find out the sum of the first pair, then we get 90 plus 100 and this gives 190. And according to the definition, we know that two angles are said to be supplementary angle if the sum of their measure is 180. And here we get the sum of their measure is 190 degree, so that the first pair would not be supplementary angle. And let's see the next. In the second, we get 45 plus 135, which gives 180 degree. That means here we can find out the sum of their measure is 180 degree. So according to the definition, the second pair will be supplementary angle. And also in the third case, we can see that 90 plus 90, which gives 180 degree, so that the third pair is obviously supplementary angle. And in the last, we can see that 160 plus 20 is equal to 180 degree. That means by the definition of supplementary angle, the fourth pair is also the supplementary angle. I hope about the you get everything easily about the complementary angle and the supplementary angle. We shall discuss about the other parts of the other types of the pairs of angle in our next video. So thank you very much for watching this video.